And report cards for students in Beloit might look a little different next year. No D's or F's. NBC 15's Barclay Pollock is here to tell us how this is possible.
Lee, those D's and F's might be replaced with M's and I's. It's all part of a new grading scale, and if it is adopted, that's not the only change students in Beloit will notice. They will also get more time to complete their assignments.
Monday, parents like Valerie Moore and teachers met to hear about a revised grading system that could be coming to their district. Moore has a freshman at BMHS and was skeptical at first, but after tonight, she's close to getting on board.
I think that the whole situation with the kids being allowed to redo work up to a certain period of time, I don't think that that will harm them, you know, because some kids learn on a different scale than others. Some don't get it right away. And
the new grading scale would work like this. If a student did less than C work on any classwork, it would go into the gradebook as an I or incomplete. The student would then have a certain amount of time to redo the classwork and earn a C or better. If the student just didn't hand in the assignment, they'd get an M for missing and have the same chance to improve their grade.
These kids are not intellectually incapable. We've got to change what we do and how we do instruction. And so
the big question for teachers at Monday night's meeting: deadlines. How much time is too much time when it comes to handing in assignments?
Whatever it was important for that student to know and to know at a high level on Friday, it's still important on Monday. So I don't understand. To me, that's arbitrary.
Arbitrary, because according to Thompson, during the first term, high school freshmen in Beloit earned 605 F's, and Thompson believes something needs to be done to help students achieve.
Thompson says starting in the fourth quarter this year, some classes will start experimenting with a new grading scale. If it is going to be a reality next year, it will first have to be approved by the school board.